Hi everyone, I'm Celeste. Welcome to my BookTube channel. Today I'd like to talk to you just briefly about short stories and where to begin, a sort of short stories 101. I do notice on BookTube that often my fellow BookTubers confess that they have a hard time getting into short stories. That's not my situation. I love short stories and always have. It's hard for me to imagine a time when I haven't read them. I think if you read picture books, chapter books, anything like that, that you must enjoy a shorter form of writing. It's just a matter of finding the right short stories. For me personally, when I was in high school, I absolutely loved our English literature textbooks and American lit textbooks and world literature textbooks, and loved the short stories in those collections. And I still have those textbooks, believe it or not. They were my introduction to the world of Roald Dahl and Alice Munro, Flannery O'Connor, Eudora Welty, and so many others. So I've always loved short stories. Once a while back, I did give you a vlog on Katherine Mansfield 101, and that was a video about where to begin with Katherine Mansfield, the author. And I chose 5 short stories and did a little mini review of each of those. So that is one way to approach the short story. You can choose an author and then read a variety of their work to see if it appeals to you and if you like that author's prose style, voice, subject matter, etc. That is one way to introduce yourself to short stories. Now another is through familiarizing yourself with a variety of stories on one subject. And since this past Sunday was Mother's Day, I thought I would talk to you about 3 short stories dealing with motherhood that I particularly enjoy. Now, lots of times when on BookTube, we who love things that are cozy, cottagecore, etc., we often tend to lean towards the sweet and endearing tales of motherhood. But I actually prefer the stories that are more complex than that, ones that are about sacrifice and sometimes pain, sometimes giving things up. To me, those actually become much more interesting and complex and memorable. So I would like to tell you about 3 stories about motherhood. The first story I'm going to mention is called The Gift, and it's by Emma Donoghue, and it comes from this collection here called The Story, 100 Great Short Stories Written by Women, chosen by Victoria Hislop. So the story is called The Gift, it's by Emma Donoghue. And it is a story written in a series of letters, so it's epistolary. And it is about a woman who lives in Jersey City who must give up her baby temporarily due to the fact that her husband has recently passed away. And the woman is now destitute. She's on very hard times and she can't support her child. So she takes the child to a home thinking that it's only temporary and that once she's back on her feet again, she'll be able to get her child. And the agency that takes her child lets her think that. Unbeknownst to her, the baby is actually sent out to a family in New York who then moved to Iowa. A lot of times these children were transported on orphan trains going out west or sent, you know, a short distance, a long distance, but in any event to a new family. And the new family did not want to give up the baby and in fact changes the baby's name. The baby's original name is Emma May Bell, and the new family changes her name to Mabel and gives her kind of a new identity. The story does go on from there, and I highly, highly recommend reading it. It's not very long. Emma Donoghue is really a good writer, and I'm looking forward to reading more of her work. Roman Fever by Edith Wharton is another wonderful story that does deal with the subject of motherhood, and in fact deals with two mothers who are on vacation with their daughters in Italy, in Rome. And so Edith Wharton often talked about the aristocracy traveling abroad, the starched and corseted members of the old New York elite, families such as the Astors and the Vanderbilts climbing the social ladder, you know, people that came from old money and others that made their fortunes more recently, but they often entertain themselves by going to the theater and the opera and sometimes by going abroad. There are two mothers who go abroad with their daughters, and their names are Mrs. Slade and Mrs. Ainsley. And this story is about them simply dining together on the terrace of a restaurant in Rome. So what could possibly be revealed in something so innocent on such a lovely late afternoon day? Well, you find out in Roman Fever. And one of them brings up something from the past. And that starts opening an entire hornet's nest of old die-hard resentments and feelings and things that come up and things they didn't know about each other. It's about love and love lost and learning the truth about things. And my copy of Roman Fever, it appears in many anthologies, but one that I have it in is The Art of the Short Story. This is a marvelous, marvelous short story collection. And if you are considering starting to get into short stories, this is a great one to have. I've held up this volume before several times. It's my go-to. Edith Wharton's writing style is so evocative and rich, and you can just imagine you're there on a terrace in Rome, looking out on the view and the food and the waiters and all of that, the marble staircases. It's a very short, short story, but well worth your while, and a different take on motherhood. It's not candy and cards and flowers. It's not that kind of Mother's Day short story. It's very different. And again, it's about something learned that people didn't know before. I was reminded of this story recently by my BookTube friend Heather, and I will post her channel information down below. Heather recently posted a lovely video where she actually went to Italy and shows us scenes of her sort of walking around Rome and seeing all the sights. So be sure to check that out down below. And finally, a wonderful accompaniment to both Emma Donoghue's The Gift and Edith Wharton's Roman Fever would be the story Désirée's Baby by Kate Chopin. And this is kind of nostalgic for me because this collection, Bayou Folk by Kate Chopin, which is a collection of short stories, this was one of the very first books that I ever featured on my BookTube channel. It's in my very first vlog, and I still love it, and I often return to it in the late spring and early summer when the weather is warming up and getting kind of balmy and humid, because that's perfect for the sort of stories set in the backwoods and bayous and backwaters of New Orleans. Kate Chopin depicts a really lush Creole world surrounded by Louisiana plantations prior to the American Civil War. It's a very harsh time because it's also a time when slavery was still legal, and a great deal of racism existed in the southern United States. The story Désirée's Baby is a very special tale. It has to do with a young woman named Désirée who has a baby, And she and her mother and her husband all start to notice something about the baby as it gets a little bit older. And this has an immediate and life-altering effect on Désirée. It's a story that's only 3 or 4 pages long, but it is just really powerful. It kind of reminds me of sort of a fable or fairy tale that would be surrounding a painting, a particular view that you might see. It's almost ekphrastic in style, almost like the author was looking at a painting and decided to create a story about what she saw in the painting. And in the story, you deal with a lot of issues of race in a very, very short space. You learn terms like la blanche, which means the white one, quadroon, which was a person of 1/4 African American descent, Creole, and also miscegenation, which is interbreeding between members of different races, and just how much it was frowned upon, and you could even be killed for it. There's a real caste system, and it's just shocking at this pre-Civil War time in Louisiana, just how much it mattered to inhabitants there. It's very sad and melancholy, but I think a very important short story and just so gorgeously evoked by Kate Chopin. So if you would like to learn more about that world and learn another story about motherhood, I would suggest Désirée's Baby by Kate Chopin. Well, I hope you had a lovely Mother's Day or celebrated your mother. I had a lovely day myself. I was treated to a delicious dinner, an Italian dinner, and I was given some lovely flowers by my son, as well as a beautiful card and a handmade picture that he did, and received several other things as well. So I was really very pleased about that and had a lovely Sunday. I hope you did too. And I will be back, I think I'll be back later this week with a little mini catch-up on Historathon, and as well I have some more animal videos coming up over the course of the next few weeks. So I hope you're enjoying your week. I hope you're doing something fun, getting out and smelling the flowers, and we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.